time to learn how to touch our partners.
Joe, I want to touch you.
I know you do, and I want to be touched. So how do we do this?
First, Joe, you're going to stand in front of me. I'm going to walk up, and I'm going to offset my body position. Right foot between your partner's legs.
My right foot is also between my partner's legs.
Now we take my right arm, and I'm going to just gently drape it low across my follows. Back.
From here, follows, I would like to connect just by bending at the elbow, and then lo and behold, that battleship, I mean, Kevin's arm is right there, so I want to make sure that I can hold on and not squeeze, but just let the weight of my arm relax across Kevin's.
Oh, that feels really nice, Joe. From here, I can actually add a little bit of energy. I just kind of ask Joe, hey, let's go over to this foot. Hey, let's come back over to this foot. It's nice and relaxed. We're not over-tensing.
Just enough so that I can feel the weight changes follow, so I know what foot I'm standing on, because it gives me a lot of information.
Now, you notice how close we are. If we get too far away, I feel like I'm reaching for Jo, and then she thinks I'm desperate, and I don't like that feeling.
No, I like to keep my men close, but not too close.
Exactly, because if I get close, then Jo's thinking,
he's
this guy's
in my
creepy,
space. He's in my bubble.
Guy. So instead, I get close, but just it's comfortable. Jo's like, wow, I can just smell your incredible cologne.
This is very true. So if we were to also add the front hand in.
Watch this, leaders. I'm going to present my left hand.
And I present fingers.
Very nice. And now we're going to show you a little more detail on this specific handhold that we use. So we're going to bring our hands up, and we're going to bend our full fingers.
From here, we're going to turn them sideways so that you can see the shape that we're making. They hopefully look something like brackets. And then from here, we're going to
have everyone have a leader hand, which will be your left hand.
And we're going to put that down towards our belly buttons.
Excellent. Now we're going to play a little game of Tetris. You're going to bring your right hand, your follow hand.
Bring your elbow straight up, and then hopefully now your fingers are facing straight down, which can now connect. So let's take a look at this up close.
So as you can see, now we are pulling gently, but not moving our hands. We're just kind of providing equal and opposite force. Now, if we remove our fingers, we can provide a little bit of a push.
So we want you to push on the fronts of your fingers. We want you to wrap your fingers back around and now pull from there. So your left hand is doing the bulk of the work, the push and then the pull, while the right hand makes sure that you have strong fingers.
Excellent. Now, sometimes it takes a lot of time to remove the fingers and push, so I'll keep them curled. I'm just going to turn sideways so you can see the little bounce. Doink, 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 doink.
How fabulous.
Incredibly fabulous. So now when we're back in closed position, I present my left hand. Jo drops hers on top. We're doing that same hand position we just showed. But leaders, I also absorb Jo's frame. Now what we mean by frame is Jo has an arm shape and a body shape. I don't want to change Jo because Jo, you're perfect.
I know. So follows, make sure that your man changes for you and not the other way around.
So I step into Jo's frame and I've adjusted my left elbow. As I step farther away from Jo, my elbow adjusts. And that's me adjusting my frame for Jo.
Oh, how very kind of him.
Now I can do the same thing, moving side to side, nice and comfortable. I'm going to rotate so you get to see all the good angles.
My goodness, that feels very comfortable.
So if we do the same thing in open position, look, I'm holding my partner by two hands. I could just hold one hand. I could hold just the other one hand, or I could hold both. And we're doing the exact same hand position with our opposite hands.
So follows, I just present good fingers, and then Kevin is able to connect to me. And then this way, we are able to stay connected, but our arms can maintain a relaxedness that would be superb to dance with.
So we're going to keep our shoulders back, our fingers strong, arms relaxed. And then throughout our dancing, sometimes we use a lot of energy, sometimes use medium, sometimes use very little. We like to do, whatever we do, we like to make it comfortable.
How very comfortable. So what we next need to talk about is dynamic frame. So follows, I would like to use equal and opposite amount of pressure with my partner.
So a good reference point is just completely relaxed arms. But then you can activate your fingers down there. It's almost like you have hooks on the end of ropes. And then you can just lift up your arms. Now this is our medium energy. And now you can sometimes we get tense. And you can
and
feel it, you can see us flexing. Ooh, Joe.
I know.
Careful of the guns there.
I know. Hopefully I don't turn too pink when I flex. So we've got a flex point, and then we can relax again, and then we can completely put our arms down. So let's call this a connection point, and that we've got dynamic frame through connection, through actually, I guess, tightness almost. Mm-hmm. And then we can relax again, and then we can put our arms down.
So we have arms down, we have connection. And then we have flexing and relaxing all the way down. Excellent. So those are just random reference points that you can use as we talk about connecting with our partner. So right now, Jo and I have that dropped feeling in our arms, but our fingers are active. Now watch, as the leader, I can lift my hand and I roll under Jo's hands to support her wrist frame. And then sometimes I will actually, when I need to move Jo, I will push and pull, and that's when we flex a little bit. Not too much, but enough.
When we do this, when Kevin pushes into me, I push into him slightly to match the same amount of pressure. When Kevin decides to sit back with the center, I would like to match him as well.
Excellent. So I think this covers our basic hand connection and arm connection and partner connection.
Dynamic frame.
You can practice just standing in closed position and moving around a little bit. Leaders, you can just kind of scoop back out. You can change your hands. Just getting comfortable with all this upper body connection.